Foundation wanted to come at you with my post-training camp, post-preseason video. You know, again, I was watching a few players last night to see if they would show up enough where they can we can keep them on the team. Some guys I was rooting for. Regular season coming up, cannot wait. You know, college football has started, so you know, really excited to see that. You know, already it started last week actually. My Hawaii Warriors lost bad too. And they put up some points, but you know, last year their defense was pretty good, but this, I don't know what happened so far. But anyway, you know, going back to the preseason and all that, I was really rooting for Showers. I like the similarity between their games, Dak and Jameel Showers. So just in case, you know, knock on wood, hopefully Dak Prescott doesn't get injured. I mean, you know, if we bring in another guy, you know, we might have to game plan different. I mean, you know, if you get Jameel Showers and Dak, you don't have to change it at that much. Probably limit the throwing areas and all that, but you know, that's why we get Zeke there for, to lead the team. But yeah, you know, and again, he didn't get really help from you know, his offensive line. You know, his receivers too. Andy Jones finally showed up, but Andy Jones at the most is gonna be a practice squad guy. You know, I thought that he would, you know, he was gonna challenge for a spot, but you know, I guess, you know, from training camp, you know, it's way different beasts. You know, I should have known better on that. But Darius Jackson, man, we cannot let this guy go. You know, I mean, I don't care what, I cannot see us letting him go. You know, special teams, catching, running, you know, blocking. I mean, he's very solid. He's very solid. I mean, he has good speed too, you know. So, and going back to Jameel Showers again, I mean, you know, on top of that, I don't really see any quarterbacks out there that I like. You know, you hear of Aaron Murray. I don't know. If the coaches are impressed by him, then bring him in. I mean, you know, that's the only thing. I mean, you know, I'm not saying they shouldn't look, but I'm just saying that I'm not really impressed with anybody coming out, you know, getting cut or anything like that. Especially some of the names that they said they potentially cutting. Hell no. But yeah, Chaz Green again. He's shown improvement. But again, if the Cowboys find somebody out there, that's very, you know, that's a blessing for us in a way. Escobar, I heard that they're shopping him around. So, you know, if we can get something for him. And because I think him and Swaim is kind of similar. Swaim is just a better blocker. Austin Traylor, he is a blocker. Hannah comes back, you know, he can be that kind of blocker and all that. Fullback between Kid Smith, I think Rod Smith, I think the brothers are going to be separated. But I think Kid Smith, he is way more versatile. He can play special teams, can play fullback. He caught the ball a couple of times, and then in a pinch he can put him as a linebacker again. So he has a lot more to offer. Defensively, you know, Okoye, I mean, he came out of nowhere, and you know, I cannot see us letting him go either. I mean, I know we need defensive ends. I mean, he's listed as a defensive end, but he looks better on the inside. But I don't know how he can let this guy go. He has a lot more talent, and he's that kid is strong. Man, you know, so, you know, and then Ryan Russell and and McAdoo showed up. I mean, Bryan Russell again improved, but you know, between the three, I would rather keep Okoye. You know, the linebackers, you know, the, most of them, a couple of them, probably this practice squad guys like Akune and King, they played well, but, you know, cornerbacks, Deji Olatoya, I thought I would have him on the team. After last night, man, I was kind of hesitant after that, you know, because Dak Swanson, he can punt return, and he was very, you know, he wasn't, you know, as aggressive. I mean, you know, but that goes back to Deji Olatoya. He's so aggressive that, you know, you like his ball skills, but at the same time, man, he cannot be getting beat like that. I said that from the first, from his interception against the Rams. I said that, you know, he's so aggressive that they're going to run that double move, and that's for sure they started doing to him, and he fell for it every time, you know. I mean, he even got, Kayvon Frazier, he took a bad angle, but he kind of put Kayvon Frazier in their predicament to begin with because he let him beat him off the snap, you know, like that. So, you know, Kayvon Frazier, it all depends on how the coaches feel about J.J. Wilcox. I mean, Kayvon Frazier really shows. I mean, there was a three play. I think it was the goal line stand where he had a couple tackles. You know, a couple good solid tackles, and then he knocked the ball away, and so he shows that he can cover and he has good enough ball skills where he can get the handle on the ball, you know. So it all depends on that. But yeah, so you know, again, if anybody comes off the wire, I mean, there's one guy I saw this a little while ago before I turned on the video. Ian Isale, and you saw what he did against the Cowboys, and I saw him against the Chiefs as well too. This kid is, he could be something. And you know, and the Rams, I mean, the people say, oh, he got cut. Well, the Rams have a very good defensive line, and they have depth at the defensive line. I knew that they would have, one of these teams would have to cut somebody that could be potentially better than our guys. And Ian Isale, I hope the Cowboys claim this kid. After what he did against us and the game against the Chiefs, you know, I'm like, I'd bring this kid in, you know. So, yeah. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to be pumping a lot of videos. I'm going to be doing division winners and stuff like that going down the list. I'm not going to give like 10 and 6 or 11 and 5 kind of records or 4 and 12. I'm not going to be doing that kind of videos. I'm just going to say who wins the division, who's the, you know, kind of go in that order. But I'll be pumping probably the most videos I will, you know, in a while. So yeah. Mahalo for watching. Next week, baby. Next week. Cowboys versus Giants. Woohoo! Are you ready? Bonnie, all the boys go Cowboys.